Hello and welcome to Post to Post, the channel where we discuss all things hockey and all teams. Recently it was announced that Kovalchuk may be returning to the NHL and the New Jersey Devils may be interested in shopping his contract or salary or however it works, I'm actually not sure. But, you know, Kovalchuk signed a $100 million 15-year deal, I think, back in 2010. He retired from the NHL 3 years after that, went to the KHL. And now he wants back, I guess. So we're here to talk about that. Justin, can you fill me in a little bit on the details surrounding this? Because you know more than me.
Yeah, after reading into it quite heavily, Ilya Kovalchuk is actually on a voluntary retirement list. So because he basically did what he did, in order for him to return to the NHL, he would have no choice but to sign a contract with the New Jersey Devils. He has no choice. They own his rights for a specific time period. Now, they've already opened the door to allow Kovalchuk to negotiate with other franchises. However, he still needs to sign the contract with New Jersey first. So that's the key piece. So it's almost as if, okay, if an organization is really interested in Ilya Kovalchuk, they'll have to work with New Jersey in order to get Jersey to sign a contract with them and then trade him to a different franchise. Kind of weird, isn't it?
That is very strange.
But then again, how many times have we really seen this situation? I mean, Lemieux retired and he came back, but did anyone really expect Lemieux to go somewhere else?
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't. But this Kovalchuk story is really quite interesting. So now you almost have to think, well, what franchises could use a guy like Ilya Kovalchuk? And I can think of a few.
I can think of a few, but does anyone really want to take the risk on Kovalchuk doing the exact same thing over again? You know, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me.
It rubs a lot of people the wrong way. I mean, it really does. And I mean, to walk away from that kind of money, like a $100 million contract. And remember at the time when he signed that contract, it was a big deal because basically they thought it circumvented the cap.
Originally wanted 17 years and the NHL said nope.
Yeah, it was held up like crazy. And that's why they kind of addressed that with the new CBA and contracts can't go over 8 years now. See, that contract came in before the new CBA and the last lockout. So it was kind of right on, you know, the tail end of that era of just weird, weird contracts.
Yeah,
and that
the DiPietro
contract. Yeah, like DiPietro, there's another prime example. That one was just outrageous. But because of what he did, I think a lot of franchises are soured on the guy and they'll just pass, you know. But there's a lot of desperate franchises out there that are looking to add some goal scoring. And Ilya Kovalchuk is that good of a goal scorer, he could return to the NHL and potentially put up 35, 40 goals.
I think he's the highest scoring Russian player of all time, isn't he?
Actually, I believe it's Ovechkin.
Oh, is it?
Has more goals than any other Russian. Oh. I think it was Fedorov before Ovechkin, if I'm wrong.
But well, he must be close.
He's not that far behind. Yeah. His numbers were outstanding.
His points per game is pretty good, too.
Yeah, and he's not far from 1,000 points either. And that's why I thought, man, you know, going to the KHL, his NHL legacy, you know, could have been so much better, in my opinion, because he's an outstanding player, an outstanding talent. Much like Ovechkin, though, just don't ask him to back check.
Yeah, well, we saw him in Atlanta during its young years. Could we see Kovalchuk in a team like Las Vegas?
Yeah.
Another new team?
Yeah, I really think Vegas would have a lot of interest in him because they'd look at him as a player that's already developed. You know, he has many years of NHL experience under his belt, and he could really be a centerpiece up front for a new franchise.
Hmm. I heard a few analysts throwing out Winnipeg as a team that might be interested. And dynamically in the lineup, I think it might work okay with all the other threats they have up front. But salary cap wise, I don't see that working at all.
Especially when a young phenom like Laine is in their lineup and he's, you know, putting up 40 goals basically for a lot less money. I think it's all going to come down to what type of contract he signs with New Jersey. And then from there, they trade him. But it's going to be a weird trade because they're going to have to almost work with another organization in order to pull it off.
Yeah.
So I don't expect New Jersey to really gain a lot because at this point, Kovalchuk's stock is only so-so, right? It's not like he played in the NHL last year and something we can really compare with. He hasn't played in the NHL in how many years now?
Yeah.
So it's kind of hard to really gauge it. So, you know, if anything, New Jersey might be picking up some draft picks for this. That's about it, in my opinion.
Yeah, they're pretty much the middleman in the situation.
Yeah, they really are. It's because of the way it's set up, and he has no choice but to sign a contract with Jersey before anything else happens.
It's very strange. Very strange.
Yeah, and the contract cannot be signed until July 1st.
Yeah.
So things are happening behind the scenes, but who knows where he ends up or if he even returns to the NHL. Maybe every franchise will say, you know what, we're not interested. Could happen.
Now, this is just, you know, this is just dreaming here a little bit. This will not happen. It's just fun to discuss. What if Washington traded Ovechkin to Las Vegas?
Yeah.
And New Jersey traded the rights of the contract of Kovalchuk to Vegas, and we had Ovechkin and Kovalchuk on the same line in Vegas. That would be a pretty interesting first year expansion team.
It would be interesting for the regular season, you wouldn't get anything in the playoffs. No. Because Ovechkin and Kovalchuk are very similar players. Yeah. You know, they're lethal goal scorers, but that's all they can do. All you're going to get out of them.
It would create a lot of Las Vegas fans, I bet, though.
It would, because yeah. I think there would be a lot of highlight reel moments going on in Vegas when you had those two on the ice together. So I think it would be quite interesting.
Let me ask you this. If you're any team in the NHL, or well, I'll just say, where do you think Kovalchuk goes? Like, if he comes back to the NHL and New Jersey does trade his rights or trade his new contract, where do you think he goes?
That's a tough one. And the other unanswered question is, does he have any preference on where he goes? You know, are there only certain organizations that he wants to discuss a potential return with or negotiate with? We really don't know. You know, everything's kind of tight-lipped, right? However, I think a team that could really use a guy like Kovalchuk would be Montreal.
Oh, don't even say it.
I'm sorry, but man, they need goal scoring. They really do. Well, and I think they could use a guy like him.
If it worked out as well as Radulov did, then I might be okay with it.
Yeah, if they could get him to buy in like Radulov, because the guy was a beast in the playoffs this year. I mean, he was the most noticeable guy on the ice, you know, night in, night out for the Canadians, in my opinion. If they could get Kovalchuk playing at that level, wow, that would be a win-win. But again, it all comes down to the dollar amount.
Yeah.
It really does. Every team can take an $8 million cap hit. Is Kovalchuk worth $8 million a year? That's up for debate as well.
I don't think I think he should get between 4 and 5 on a very short-term contract. There's no way he's getting a long-term contract right now.
And the other question is, what kind of money is he looking for? We don't know.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if he was going after $100 million the last time, then you can't. You have to imagine that he's still looking to get paid well. So.
Definitely, because I think given his age, this would probably be his last contract that he'd be looking for.
Absolutely.
And I think he'd be looking for minimal 5 years, I would think.
I think that's too long. I think two years is as far as he can go.
And I know if I was an organization, I had interest in him, I would only offer him a 1 year. Yeah. Prove to me that you're loyal and that you're still capable in the NHL. If you can prove it for that year, then I'll reward you with something, you know, longer term.
Exactly.
That's just my mindset.
I mean, Montreal did that with Alexander Semin 2 years ago. It didn't work out. They did it last year with Radulov 1 year, and it worked out this time. So
yeah, really
he'll be rewarded. I think that's a good idea is for the team to give them a 1 year contract and see how it goes. A proving ground, basically.
That's what I would do.
Well, my opinion is I hope every NHL team takes a stand and nobody signs him, and he's not allowed back in the league because of what he did. I don't think that he deserves to be back in the NHL, regardless of how much he wants to be. So that's just my opinion.
Yeah, and for my opinion, my closing opinion, I'm not the biggest fan of Ilya Kovalchuk. He can be a lethal goal scorer, but I find he has a bit of an attitude problem, and you're not going to get that 100% commitment out of him game in, game out. He kind of reminds me of Kovalev. He'll play when he wants, but if he's on 100%, he is capable of taking a game over single-handedly. But what are you going to get from him night in, night out? You really don't know. He's one of those players. He's going to put in that effort when he wants.
Exactly. Well said. We'll leave it at that. So thank you guys very much for watching. Make sure you leave your comments down below on how you feel about the Kovalchuk situation. If you're new to Post to Post and this is your first video, we hope you hit the subscribe button. If you like this video, hit the like button, and we'll see you in the next one. Adios.